Hi, I'm Mike Massimino.
I'm Don Pettit, and this is the International Space Station Science Garage.
And today, Don and I are going to speak with two friends of ours, Chris Hadfield and Tom Marshburn.
What about the experience of being up there? I mean, what sticks with you guys now? What was it like?
For me, certainly, is all the great things you experience looking out the window, all that, but sharing it with people.
Yeah,
it's such a great crew.
Some of the best moments, I think, is where you you think, hey, you know, I haven't looked out the window in a little while, and you float out the window, and there's one of the other guys there already, and the two of you come up, and it's almost like, I don't know, maybe coming into the Sistine Chapel, where you come in, and there's a hush and an absolute reverence for just the ancient, unmistakable beauty of where you are, and you float up there, and you don't even need to talk about it. You know, you're both just in awe of where you are, and you share it just by floating next to each other, and it unwraps itself all the time.
Yeah,
it's just, oh, you go, wow, look at that over there.
And you think you know the Earth. You look at it. You see, India's hazy, yeah, and Australia's red, but then you start to get the little details, and you read about it. I greatly enjoyed learning high school geography. Except the geologic kind, and just discovering new nuances every time. You just want it, as you know, you can't peel your eyes away because there's always something new to discover. Mm-hmm. I've told people I fell back in love with the Earth, maybe kind of like a teenager leaving their family and turning back and saying, you know, my parents were really pretty cool.
Does
that happen with your kids?
It's coming.
Take a decade or two.
You'll turn back into human beings.
But you fall in love with it. You want to see it again. You want to see all the places out there, and you want to take care of it.
Yeah, it made me feel, even on the short shuttle flight, I started to see the world less as where I'm from and as one place, you know, as like the whole thing. But boy, after you've been up there months, it's just a bunch of people that are just like you, doing their best wherever they happen to be around the planet, trying to solve their particular problems. And for me, the sense of connection with people, I think, got stronger. Which is weird. You'd get a sense of isolation.
Right.
I really felt the opposite, which surprised me, and just in my viewing of a kinship with everybody in the world.
Yeah.
I think it's just because you see it so often as a complete set over and over again.
And I think that's accentuated by how fragile it all looks. I mean, people are still living on the edges of banks and on coastlines, even cities at night. It's certain areas where you would expect microorganisms to collect, you know, which it sometimes looks like, little tiny colonies around there. And so the fragility of human life on this huge sphere, not to mention how tiny that is compared to the huge Milky Way you can see beyond it,
really
makes you, as you said, just a real connection to the people.
Yeah, life, the planet will go on with or without us. Mm-hmm.
The planet is as brutally tough.
Yes.
It'll shed us in a heartbeat, but we would prefer to keep things sort of stable.
Yeah.
It's almost like, okay, where's the mold going to grow in my house? The most likely places where, and that's kind of where everybody lives, you know, the places where it's easiest
for everything to contaminate with humanity.
And that life collects in all those places.